grandfather was good friends with Horace Pippin, and they would trade, his grandfather also was not only a seakeeper, he also had bees. Uh-huh. And Horace Pippin was, had, oh, I can't think of the word. Arthritis. And he, so he would trade his seeds. Horace Pippin had a lot of seeds, and he would trade seeds to William's grandfather for bee sting therapy from his
bees.
So this fish pepper, it's a very culturally significant pepper. It was the most popular pepper in Baltimore in the around the turn of the century in Baltimore in the United States. Most of the cooks and caterers in Baltimore were African American, and they had a very rich culinary culture, and the fish pepper was the most important pepper.
Later.
And I was surprised that even though it was such a popular pepper, it really was lost throughout time. He has a lot of varieties with really rich storytelling and like that, but that was my favorite story. Yeah. I thought that was really cool. Someone else that we work with, his name is Stephen Smith, and he is only 19 years old, but he's like the premier heirloom corn breeder in the United States. Most extreme obsession with corn that I've ever seen any person ever have. It's really fun. He knows every story. He knows every story. He has a collection that would blow your mind. And he's also really good. He's really obsessed with beans too.
I get.
These are two crops that are really important to us in the U.S. because they're native to the United States. They're so well adapted to the U.S. Unfortunately, corn is abused in the United States, but we're trying to bring back the heritage varieties that are not overused. And he's working to acclimate some of our, we have some really beautiful varieties of corn that are from South America. And they're from high altitude regions, like in the Andes and Peru. And he's working to acclimate them to a lower altitude so that we can grow them in the U.S. Bigger varieties. One of my favorite varieties from Peru is a variety called, they call it maíz morado, or also coolie corn, and it's a black corn, and you boil it, and it makes a purple drink. Oh. And you add pineapple skin and cinnamon and clove, and it's very high in antioxidants. It's really good for you. Of course, they load it down with sugar, but you don't have to. But it's really delicious, and it's really good for you, and we're trying to have it. It's a black corn, but when you boil it, it's purple. This is why our company is having success, because we're bringing enjoyment back into eating. And to be honest, in the United States, there hasn't been a lot of enjoyment in the food process in a while. It's been very homogenized.
After seeing,
I experienced the purple corn in its actual home region in the Peruvian Amazon. Actually, in Lima, Peru, which is a little bit higher. When I visited for Baker Creek, I traveled to the Peruvian Amazon and also to Lima, Peru, and I had it.
Ah, yeah.
Really good. Mm-hmm.